population ecology is a study of processes that affect the distribution and abundance of animal and plant populations. Population is a subset of individuals of one species that occupies a particular geographical area and, in sexually reproducing species, interbreeds. Birth rates, death rates, immigration, and immigration are all examples of limiting factors that affect a population. Population ecologists commonly divide the factors that regulate the size of populations into two categories, density-dependent and density-independent. A birth rate or death rate that does not change with the population is said to be density-independent, and a death rate that rises as the population density rises is said to be density-dependent.
Density-independent. Density-independent factors affect the same portion of individuals in a population regardless of population density. Two examples are weather and climate.
Density-dependent. Density-dependent factors intensify as the population increases in size. Many factors that regulate population are density-dependent. The first category, competition for resources. In a crowded population, increasing population density intensifies competition for declining nutrients and other resources, resulting in a lower birth rate. Crowding can reduce reproduction in plants, and many animal populations also experience internal competition for food and other resources. An example, on Hersha Island, ecologists study soy sheep. They found that the effects of increasing density on birth rate are the strongest for the youngest sheep that reproduce, one-year juveniles. The second category, territoriality. In many vertebrates and some invertebrates, territoriality can limit population density. In this case, territory space becomes the resource which individuals compete. An example, cheetahs are highly territorial. Using chemical communication to warn other cheetahs about their territorial boundaries, by maintaining a territory, it increases the likelihood that a cheetah will capture enough food to reproduce.
Predation. Predation may be an important cause of density-dependent mortality. If a predator encounters and captures more food as the population density of the prey increases, as prey population builds up, predators may feed preferentially on that species, consuming a higher percentage of individuals. For example, trout may concentrate for a few days on a particular species of an insect that is emerging from its aquatic larval state and then switch to eating another insect species as it becomes more abundant.
The accumulation of toxic waste can contribute to density-dependent regulation of a population size. Example, in laboratory cultures of microorganisms, metabolic byproducts accumulate as the populations grow, poisoning the organism. Intrinsic factors. For some animal species, intrinsic psychological factors rather than the extrinsic environmental factors appear to regulate population size. An example, white-footed mice in a small field enclosure will multiply, but eventually the reproductive rate will decline until the population ceases to grow. In conclusion, in populations, there are two factors that regulate the size of populations, density-independent and density-dependent. A birth rate or death rate that does not change with population is said to be density-independent, and a death rate that rises as the population density rises is said to be density-dependent. Most of the factors that regulate population growth are density-dependent. Completion for resources, territoriality, disease, predation, toxic waste, and intrinsic factors are all density-dependent.
Predation. Here, we see a cricket, roaming the cage of a young reptile. Slowly but surely, the reptile will pounce, and we will see nature at its worst. Okay, now I just gotta get your lizard to eat the thing. And there we go. Nature at its finest. The lizard has eaten the cricket. And that's predation at its best. Dude, he's taking forever to swallow that thing. There he goes. prey is now done for.